was pretty much straight after that. And even those last couple of games, I thought that we started to think about it a little bit and what combinations we might use. And those last two games gave us a lot of confidence, and it was great to come out here and play a pretty perfect game.
And just to start off with, you had that loss against New Zealand. Did you have any doubts, or what did you feel that when you actually had that loss, what did you have to improve on?
Oh, you've always got to improve, and you know, I wasn't worried after the loss. You know, we did a lot of things right, but we just couldn't get over the line. So, you know, I think we built throughout the tournament really well. We gained momentum and we gained confidence, and you know when we came in today, we had a lot of players in form, so that was what it came down to.
Australia hit 18 sixes over the tournament, more than any other team. What's the secret to this kind of power over the ropes? What kind of weight training do you do? What sort of physical preparation do you do to get that kind of power?
Oh, to start off with, you just swing really hard. That's something I think about. But we do a lot of training, strength training. I think a lot of it's about timing rather than actual brute strength, and we've got a few players in our team that are able to do that, so it was nice to be able to do that today. I think it's certainly advantageous to be able to clear the rope, especially in T20, so I think throughout the tournament that's certainly been a real positive for us.
Sarah, you seem to be bowling well at the death and dedicated death bowler. How much has your cricketing family sort of, have you had any input from that bowling at the end?
I've learned a lot from my brothers over the years who I grew up playing cricket with, obviously, and yeah, it's nice to be able to execute when Meg gives me the ball.
Is that a role that you want to play? Is that something which was decided before the World Cup?
Yeah, I think so. I've always bowled a lot at the death, and it's something that I thrive off, a bit of a pressure situation, so whenever Meg throws me the ball, I'm just ready to go.
And Meg, compare this to the last couple of World Cups. How does this one differ?
Oh, it's different. You know, I think we've got quite a young side, but we're also experienced in tough situations and pressure situations. So, you know, I think we played really good cricket throughout the tournament, and to win so convincingly in the final today was, yeah, just great. And I think the bowlers set it up for us. They started off really well, executed well, and it's just, yeah, really happy to be a part of it.
Does it sort of wash away a bit of that Ashes pain?
Certainly does, yeah. Obviously, we were disappointed with that, but... to be able to win three 2020 World Cups in a row is something really special.
Got more World Cup wins than the men now, and everyone talks about the domination of the Australian cricket men. How do you feel about that? Not many people focus on the women. What's the...
Oh, look, we'd obviously love to see the men doing well. I think Australian cricket is in a good place at the moment. They've had a great summer, and now it's good that we've been able to top that off as well. So hopefully, next time they can get the win as well. But, yeah, we're... We're in a pretty good place, Cricket Australia, at the minute.
Meg, your overall experience from the tournament and Bangladesh as the host?
Oh, I think it's been great. We've enjoyed ourselves here. It's been something very different and something we've had to adjust to, but we've loved the whole time. Solet was great for us, and to be able to get back to Dhaka and play in a couple of finals was really topping it off.
Meg, last Silet part, we saw that you are joined in flash mob dancing. What are you saying about this dancing and how enjoy this?
Oh, it was good fun. My dance moves are pathetic, so I can't believe it went out to the world. But yeah, it was a bit of fun. It was great to see the smiles on the young kids' faces. And I think it was a great experience. Obviously, every time I see it, I get a little bit embarrassed. But it was a great experience. Sorry? Oh, I doubt it. Nah. Terrible. Not good.
Meg, you started with a defeat against New Zealand. Looking back, do you think it worked as a good wake-up call for your team?
Yeah, it might have been. I think, it was a tough match first up. New Zealand are a good side, and we didn't get everything right, but we did get a lot of things right. So it just sort of made us focus on a few things that we needed to work on, and I think, you know, as the tournament went on, we worked on those, and I think we got it all pretty right today.
Meg, coming into this tournament, Jodie Fields had led you to the World T20 win and the World Cup win last year. So in that sense, there was some, you know, captaincy pressure on you. How did you adjust to the role? And just tell us about the role, how you enjoyed through the tournament.
Yeah, it's something I've thoroughly enjoyed. It's, you know, I've had to step up pretty quickly. It happened a lot quicker than I thought, but, you know, heading into the tournament, I knew that I'd have a lot of support around me, and the coaching staff, especially Coach Catherine Fitzpatrick and my vice captain, Alex Blackwell, have helped me a lot. And, you know, there's no doubt I've still got a lot to learn, but it's been a fantastic experience to be exposed to pressure situations, and really happy to be able to come out on top.
Sarah, we noticed you've got some writing on your arm. Is that something particularly significant, or can you tell us what it says?
It says, God gives the greatest battles to the strongest soldiers, and that's something I really do believe in, and yeah, it's something that I hold really close to me.